我是 Cherish， 来自亚马逊卖家律师事务所。那今天非常荣幸邀请美国律师同事 Jason 先生来去分享关于在亚马逊平台出现二手在卖的问题该如何去处理。
Hello, my name is Jason. I'm a paralegal here at ROSENBAUM FAMULARO, and I'm here to talk to you about that notification for used products sold as new. What to do and how to prevent this from happening to you. A lot of preventative measures here for this notification to make sure that you don't receive this notification in your inbox. One of the most easiest things to do is an adequate proof of purchase for these products themselves. Too often do we have individuals that provide us with invoices that Amazon will not accept. Amazon will not accept Google Docs. They will not accept Microsoft Word products. They will not accept Excel sheets or Proforma invoices. So when you're vetting your supplier, you want to make sure that they're able to give you a detailed commercial invoice. This first and foremost will protect you from ever receiving this used, sold as new notification. Okay, so with that being said, on this invoice, you want to have as much detail as possible about the products that you're actually selling. You want to have detailed lines, you want to have product codes, SKU numbers, any type of identifier to make it known that this product was purchased from an authorized retailer and that it is in fact new. With that, supporting documentation from very reputable manufacturers can be provided, such as a letter from the brand authorization individual. For instance, you know, Sony or Philips or what have you. Whoever is obtaining these products and selling them to you, if they are an authorized distributor, they can give you these authorization letters. That way it further cements your case with Amazon and proves that the products in fact you have are new. With that being said, Amazon's definition of new, look it up, read it, know it. Your definition of new may be different than theirs. The definitions can be construed based on what information is provided on the detail pages and images. With Amazon's definition of new, these products have to match exactly. They have to be manufactured new. They have to be in the original packaging, and that packaging and those products have to match that detail listing page exactly. If any of the images, even if the packaging has been updated, don't match exactly what the Amazon customer sees on that detail listing page, and they get a brand new product that's in a different package, that could get you with that used, sold as new notification. So always make sure that you verify those detail listing pages, you check all the images, and the product that you're selling matches those detail listing pages exactly. So lastly, putting together a plan of action to address this. Should you get this notification, there's a lot of different common causes here. It's not always going to be your fault. Sometimes you can do everything in the world to prevent this from happening, and you can still get this notification. Some common issues would be damage in shipping. Sometimes, you know, this happens. A product is damaged in shipping. The customer opens it up. It's a bottle of shampoo. It's been opened. It's everywhere. They file this complaint. Next thing you know, you get that notification that the product was used when obviously it wasn't. So you have to look at this as a case-by-case basis. First and foremost, you want to always make sure to address these matters with Amazon's customers as quickly as possible. You want to make sure that you keep them happy, and then you go backwards and you see what the cause of the issue was. You want to take your time when answering these notifications. You want to make sure that you address these matters completely. And whether it's a suspended listing or a suspended account, you should treat them exactly the same. Because if you ignore one suspended listing for this matter, it can very, very quickly turn into a suspended account. So you want to always treat these matters as if they can always lead to this. It's always worst case scenario. Make sure that you always put the customers first. Amazon has a philosophy of being obsessed with their customers. That is a philosophy that you have to adapt as well if you want to be successful on this Amazon platform. Of course, here at ROSENBAUM FAMULARO, if you should get to that point where your listing is suspended, if your account is suspended, we can always help you get back on track. We can put together a great plan of action. We can investigate these matters for you, find out what happened, put together corrective actions for you and future preventative measures to ensure that Amazon sees that these issues will not reoccur in the future, and then we can get your account reinstated and get you selling as quickly as possible.
非常非常感谢 Jason 今天非常分享了非常多的细节。那对于亚马逊卖家呢，如果说遇到二手在售的问题，一定一定要提供产品发票，一定要找厂家，获得品牌的授权，同时再加上行动方案， 在这种情况下才能够真正解决问题。同时在亚马逊平台，刚刚他也很明显的提到，对于卖家而言，大家对新品以及亚马逊对新品的定义和理解是不一样的，所以我们一定要找足证据来去证明自己的产品是真实的，而且是新的，这样的话你的产品才能够恢复，才能够继续卖。当然当一个 listing 出现问题的时候，也一定要及时去处理，这样的话就不会影响到后面的账号。因为有的时候产品在二手在售的话，被亚马逊发现，有的时候只是移除 listing， 但有的时候就是会封账号，这样是很得不偿失的，因为这是一个很小的问题，望卖家朋友请注意这一些。